Comment about the K-12 implementation. If you win a Senate seat, what will you change?
Not really change, but hasten the implementation.
Okay, what's wrong with K-12 today?
They're not ready to implement. May mga probinsya, may mga syudad, nakulang ang classrooms. May mga probinsya na syudad, tama ang classrooms. They have enough classrooms. Pero wala naman equipment and facilities. You must remember,
why is the Pinoy administration saying, DepEd is saying, we have built the most classrooms. We've reached the target. Do you believe that?
But they base that on the classroom shortage 2010.
Oh God.
Pero
okay.
Moving forward, wala pang data doon.
Okay.
So what they are saying is that the backlog, which
of
they
2010.
Define as 2010. Okay. Pero yung moving forward, wala pa yung datos doon. They may have it, but hindi pa na-release. Not only that, there are 4 tracks to choose from, di ba? Yung tech voc track, which they intend to have 48% of our students from grade 10 to grade 11 going into that. So that's about 600,000 to 700,000 students. Ang importante sa tech voc track is really equipment. But take a look at the, our schools, especially in the provinces. Wala naman equipment. So anong training? Ang sabi nila...
Well, it's like, it seems, is it all talk for you now without really... In other words, the law is there, the concept is there.
It's a good concept.
Okay.
It's a very good concept. Definitely K-12...
We're not putting our money where our mouth is. Parang ganon.
Hindi
tech book, walang gamit.
Kasi hindi mabilis eh, yung implementation na nangyari. So you ask me, if I become senator, what will I do? What I will do is I will ensure oversight function. Let's act faster. Let's provide all this equipment that's needed. If classrooms are needed, gawin na natin agad-agad. Hindi tayo pwede dito masyadong ano eh, pabagal-bagal eh. Kailangan mabilis na action eh. Because it's being implemented already starting June. And what whether we like it or not, since
this
the Supreme Court...
This is full K-12, no?
Yes, since the Supreme Court has already said that they will not entertain the TRO, so talagang all systems go yan. Tayo naman, we have been a critic of the implementation, but if it's going to be implemented already, I agree with Secretary Luistro, everyone should get together, everyone should come together, and we should find the solutions. And ako naman, I point out the defects that I see for them to correct it. But now that, kailangan full throttle na, magtutulungan tayong lahat.
Okay,
that's
I'm
not
curious,
a question.
Would you want to be education secretary?
Well, I'm very interested in education. I think that is really going to be the key for our development, especially with ASEAN regionalization happening.
Because your father, of course, I'd like to say, your father was foreign affairs secretary, your father was budget secretary, your father was executive secretary, am I right?
Yes.
He handled all those three
budget
major...
secretary.
Yeah, budget secretary,
finance,
executive
yeah.
secretary. We're talking about former Secretary Bert Romulo, huh?
Yes.
And then he finance secretary too?
Yes.
So would any of your father's former posts interest you? Or is education closer to your heart?
Well, education is closest to my heart. Pero I guess it's not right also for me to talk about those things because whoever becomes the president should have a free hand in choosing who he or she wants to... Mm-hmm.